For workers at a manufacturing plant that was nearly burned to the ground a month ago, Shelter Enterprises, which makes packaging products, is still charred from the flames from the outside. But its owner says on the inside, business is starting up once again. Chris Gloninger joins us live now from Cohozen. Chris, we're told production resumed this morning, hours ago.
Jerry, that start time has been pushed back a little bit. One of the parts from the machine hadn't arrived and they had to pick it up this morning. So the new ETA for the production line to fire back up is after lunchtime. I spoke with the CEO earlier this morning, Jeffrey Myers, and that's what he told me. It's a big day here, though, at Shelter Enterprises. Employees returning back to work, and the production will start up again for their styrofoam-based products. The fire occurred about a month ago, and this is video when we got to the scene shortly after the fire happened. You can see it, flames shooting through the roof. It crippled and halted production of their styrofoam-based products. The company immediately went back to work following the fire. 16 employees have been back at work, but even today, 24 employees are still without a job. Five more will be returning back to work next week. Owner Jeffrey Myers told me it was a larger emotional loss than financial loss.
It's not so much how much we've lost. It's just the emotional pain we've taken. You know, the money can be gotten back. That's just hard work and getting back to work and getting our customers back and shipping materials again. It hasn't been that difficult of a financial loss at this point. It's just more of an emotional loss, and I still have people that aren't working, so that hurts more too.
I know you have pretty high confidence that they'll be back eventually.
Everyone that wants to come back to work will be back eventually.
When they receive styrofoam, it's in the consistency of salt. Then they puff it up by processing it in one of their machines. This is from one of my styrofoam coffee cups, a very similar product. And you can see the small beads that form the sides of the cup. And if that's what you see when you look real closely, it's not a consistent product, but they press it together. Now, they don't make coffee cups here, but they do make stuff that's used in everyday life. They make packing supplies, and they also use styrofoam-based insulation. That's what they produce here. They say that their clients have been supportive through the entire process. They've been calling and checking in to see when production would start back up. Some good news, their raw materials and some of their finished products were stored at a different facility, so they were not lost in the fire. So production and shipping was able to resume right after the fire. So that was some good news. Again, he cannot put a dollar amount on the money lost in the machines and the labor and how much product that they weren't able to make. Also, he said to get to back to that 100% mark of production, it will take probably another year before things get back to normal. We are live in Cohoes. Chris Gloninger, CBS 6 News.